All right, kicking off from Gloucester, make our way up to, is it the Magoney Lookout? Magoney? I've got no idea. We're just going to get up there and have a look. We'll load it up. Mark from Total Riding Adventures on my left. There's Breno from Two-Wheeled Sparky on the right. Let's give it a run. And we are out of here. Ooh. Great stop. We actually came through a fair amount of rain on the way up. So we've all got the wet weather gear on. And according to the radar, they're supposed to be clearing up from Gloucester up to Walcha. However, I don't think any of us have got any faith in what the radar is saying, so we'll just check that out when we get up there. First time I've been on in the wet weather on the Knobbies, and with no word of a lie, I've got a lot more confidence in these tyres than I had in the Motos Tractionators. So I'm pretty stoked with that. With this low-level cloud, I reckon we're still going to get a fair amount of rain. Here it comes. And if we do, well, gonna make some changes. Anyhow, we'll get up to the lookout. Quick pit stop up there to, you know, just, I don't know if the lookout's going to, look at the cloud. Yeah, we'll have a quick pit stop up there and check out the views. Cut a corner, why don't you, Campo? Okay. It's a popular spot up here where a lot of riders will come up and check this spot out. God, they need some work on the bloody car park. Let's have a quick look. Lovely, look at that. Alright, we're getting the track running. All good? Alright, let's hit it then. So heading out towards Bundook first. And most of this is paved. It's pretty good pavement usually in the dry. It's nice and fast and twisty, you can have a bit of fun with it. For me, today, the biggest test is the wet weather and the Knobbies. And without a doubt, the Continental TKC 80 on the front, the Midas EO 7 Plus on the back, through this wet weather has been just awesome. A lot more confidence on the wet pavement than I have with the GPS tractionators from Motos, and I just didn't like them. So I took those off and they still had about 10 to 15,000 Ks left in them at least. Yeah, it just got to the stage where I did not enjoy riding that thing at all. But now we're on great rubber. We're going to head out, have some fun, and see how the rest of today pans out. Should be really good. Camping out tonight, we've got the campsite sussed out. There's going to be some great food, great entertainment, food trucks, coffee carts, all that kind of gear, you name it. It's going to be awesome. I don't think we see many water crossings on this one, but coming back on Sunday, we are going to be doing the 20 creeks at Nundle, which look, I'm quite keen to check it out, see what it's going to be like. Should be good fun. But we'll sit back, we'll enjoy some of the stunning views on our way out to Bundook. This is Bundook Road. Back on Google and tracking everything through Guide GPS, so I can go back and have a look at our track. And you see I've got this new mount up here for the phone. which is which I'm pretty keen to give a good run. It's funny because it blocks out, stops me from looking straight down in front. Whee, here we go, dirt road. Heavy on the brakes. Now I've also got, you'll see I don't have my little tyre pressure sensor monitor system thing here. I've actually got a different one called Phobo Bike 2. So new lugs on the wheels, and then I've got an app that comes direct through the phone. The app's been really good. It'll alert me when the pressure's low and it'll all come up. On here it will do monitor temperature as well. If I remember to do it, I'll show you that a little bit later on. If that's something that interests you, or you're keen to get a TPMS, I'll put a link down below to where I got that. You can check that out as well. All right, so it begins. Here we go. Would be good if I focused on what was going on. Yeah. S3 for the dirt today on the Africa Twin. Gearing's a little bit quicker, a little more adaptive. It's good for the dirt. I've only been using it the last couple of rides. Alright, be aware of trucks. Could get a few of those around today. Taking it pretty easy. It's pretty wet, pretty slippery, and very scenic. Gotta get the photo, mate. Look at it. Hey, I am today, look at it. Big dirty turd. Well, you just couldn't hold on. What a great spot, look at that. All right, so after the mandatory photo, we'll keep carrying on. It's all good. very twisty roads. And it's only 10 o'clock. We've got stacks of time to get up there. Excellent, here we go. And that was a little bit on the slippy side, that clay, so I don't know how this mud's going to go up here, because it's still awfully moist in this area. Not. It's going to be very interesting. All right, let's even get away from the showers that are coming up. Just trying to avoid that at the moment, so we might hold off on any further stops for now. There it is there, look at that. You bugger. You little bugger. Just one small shower that I'm getting the sprinkles from now, and it's all coming this way. And here we are, finally on the dirt. A lot of firsts here for me with these on the knobbies on the wet dirt. So in my mind I'm like cautious, but also want to give it a little bit because it's a lot of fun. Sitting down a lot today, need to conserve energy. The Gloucester River, Noel Devenish Memorial Bridge. Over we go. That's a big one. There's a bit of water in it after the rain we've had. Speaking of rain, here it comes. Really wanted to get this wet weather gear off. I'm roasting in this thing. This is one of my favorite locations. Love this bridge. Big fish in there too. Alright, guys want to pull over? Let me just go and get a spot. It's only a little shower if you wanted to hang around.
Yeah, that's in my brain when I was leaving the other day. We were coming up, I gone, there's this really nice.
Yeah, I love this spot. This Tiri bridge is gorgeous.
Alright, well, we'll pull it up here for a bit and just stand by for it.
Yeah, we'll just have a look for five if it doesn't piss off. Sounds I don't know, good. Can you fly the drone in this sort of rain?
No, God, no. No, I'll just wait for it to pass. It might pass shortly.
I wouldn't think so. Look, I wouldn't do it personally, but I've seen other guys do it.
So. Yeah, no, I wouldn't. It's too expensive.
So the lads are happy, which means I'm happy. Over we go. This is the Tiri Bridge. If you get a chance to stop down here, do it. Sit down for a little bit and catch some breath. So far so good, eh? A little bit of bitumen. Good mix of bitumen and dirt. Allows us to pick up the pace a little bit. Gonna stop off in a little while and just get rid of the wet weather gear. Weather pending, of course. And just see if we can strip it down a touch because it's getting bloody hot right now. This is absolutely gorgeous up through here. Look at it. Rain, look at it. There's a bit of water in there. So this is this Enfield Range Road straight up here. I'm just going to see if the camera's a bit clear. There's a few of them by the looks of it too. Might, hey?
This is a section you said we probably wouldn't get through if we go that way. The way we were going to do,
yeah.
We were going to go that way.
Really?
Yeah, come here. We're at that intersection. That was that one I said to you. We may be able to go that loop.
Oh, yep.
You just turn us onto it.
So you want to go, yeah, we want to go the other way, do we?
Yeah, well, what we discussed, we're going to go that way, because you're worried about us not being able to get through here.
Yeah, that's right. There was a couple of areas that would be a bit dodgy.
Yeah.
All right, well, we can keep...
take the chance and keep going, or go that way. I'm going to leave it up to you, but it sounds like exciting footage.
Yeah, might throw a spanner in the works for the day, though, that's all. Yeah, look, we can keep peeling through there and take that out to Knowendock.
Yeah, because that's the one that takes us to Knowendock. It's,
Yeah. All right, we'll take it all the way up.
You know, that's the Knowendock there.
Yeah.
Or that other loop, which does... Oh, shit, keep doing that bloody thing. Which does take us, like, a fair way up in front if we go straight ahead.
Yep.
I can't see a problem with it, to be honest with you. I reckon we'll get through here.
Well, we got the time to have a look, and we can always...
Oh, shit. Did you want to go...
we can always come back.
20k or something, have a look?
Yeah, let's go and have a look. Yeah, the roads are great.
These are awesome.
All right, so this is going to be a little interesting. This is where we're looking at this road and thinking that it might not be advantageous for us to go through, but we'll go and have a look. And you know, made up a fair amount of time at the moment. Should be quite specky through here as well. He's going to give it a run. There he goes. Let's even get some footage of these guys doing their thing. Oh, wow. That is beautiful. Feel the big twin moving around under me. She's having a ball. Just enjoying these beautiful views though, and that those showers just sitting over there. If we're lucky, we might get away from the showers themselves. That's awesome. We didn't. Oh, that's slippery as. So I'm just going to take it real easy on this stuff. It feels to be getting more and more slippery, so I'm not overly keen on doing too much silly stuff. Wow, look at that road. Look at that view. Oh, look for the cows. Distance so I don't get any poo flicked in my face. That shower up there on the left, man, it's pretty heavy. Building up, getting some power in it. Tires are still on highway pressures, so just going nice and easy. Those red trees. Oh my God, look at them. We'll be right back. There he goes, big guy. Nice work. Legend. Damn! How nice is that? That's beautiful terrain.
Good decision you're turning right there, Brett.
How nice is this?
It's incredible, isn't it?
Yep, so it says we've got about 8.5k until we get to Enfield Road. This is looking amazing. Whoa, slippy slip. Fucking slippy slip. Spoke too soon. Yeah, I just thought I better turn off the traction control. Yeah, Bruno. Hate mud. I hate mud. It's horrible. Try and get it all off. Damn it. Confidence blown, I'm going to take my time.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
I'm just
behind. I'm fucking not happy about this at all, anyhow.
It's funny, isn't it? It's like, look, and it's funny stuff.
Yeah. We got 55 Ks of this. 55 call. 30? You reckon? Alright, we'll bring it up. Get it up here. Okay, so the master has spoken. Tire pressure is way too high. We're dropped down to 20 psi front and rear because I'm quite edgy on the dirt. You know, I hate mud. Don't like mud. Don't like slippery mud. Not having fun. It's supposed to be clear weather. That's what the forecast said. It's still yuck. All right. See how this feels. Okay. Where are the lads? Get out of the flies. Breno probably wanted to tell me as well about tyre pressure, but that's all right. Live and learn. There he comes. There's the big fella up in the hill. Okay, step it up a little bit, make a move. Oh yeah, okay. That was a bit slippery, but I had a lot more grip. That was good. Wow, okay. Conserve some energy and sit back and enjoy the ride again. So much better. He is too good. Of course, he's going to take the piss out of me for it tonight, though, I can guarantee it. Damn, that's a long way down. Yeah, boy! Woo! You know what I found the last, those two times that I ran off the run, off the track is that target fixation of looking into the dirt, and I just could not get my eyes off it. I'm pretty sure most people have experienced it, but damn, it's a pain in the butt. Once you get that. I just had that realization that I'm out in the middle of nowhere in the mountains with all my camp gear, got a destination in mind with a couple of great lads. How did I get here? Seriously, wow. Let's get out of that rut, yeah? Oh yeah, that'll do. It's long. Ready? Yeah. Go. I thought, oh, it's only small. Yep. Now everyone can get through. Oh fuck. Okay, All right. Damn, this rain. Oh, we are in the clouds now. Oh my God, I can't see a thing. Visibility, altitude, water, slipperiness. Embrace the challenge, right? And I'm getting hungry, but we're not eating up here. I know we're going downhill now, so that's good. Oh, Jesus. They had a water crossing to wash the bike with. 26 Ks. That's the Enfield Road, so I'm hoping Enfield Road's going to be a little better than this. Cool. Bruno's back a bit, just in case I come off. Pinch, 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 pinch. Watch out for the ruse. You know what I'm really happy about? My feet are dry. Dry as a bone. Thank you, Alpine Stars. Whoop, bump. Oh, it is so good being out of that mist. Oh my. Back's tightening up, body's tightening up. Hell of a ride. I don't even think we're halfway yet. I'd have to check the map. Ooh, big rock. Maybe we should pull in here and have a bite to eat. Get over. Thought we better come and eat with the cool kids. Right, quick short break, a bit of lunch, and the cloud has followed us in. Shit of a thing that it is. You know what I've just realised too? The camera's been on horizon steady the whole time up, I think, so it's going to make for an interesting video. Walcha in the next couple of hours. Keen?
Always keen.
As we kick on through the state forest. So plan is, as we were discussing just then, get into the showground. Actually no, I think we're going to refuel first. Get fuel, supplies if we need to, if we can fit them in. I don't think I can fit them in, I've got no room. And then to the showground where we'll set up. Oh wow, look at that. What's that up there? Big bird. So yeah, we'll set up, get comfy, get the fire on, hot shower, beer, and whatever else. Big tree or dead roo? Oh, wombat. Poor wombat. Oh, and it looks like we're going to come into this this area of haze once more. I'm just going to crack this a little bit and get some air in here. Look, the Penlock's been awesome, but with my heavy breathing and the amount of time that we've been out here today, it's kind of having a few issues. But yeah, look, still highly recommend them. I think they're great. You're about to see me crank up the heater grips. My hands are a little bit freezing. Just a little bit. So it's a pretty good test of the Kamani Rama too. This jacket that I'm wearing, because I've taken off the wet weather gear, it's cool. Mark was saying it's about 12 degrees at the moment. That's a little bit on the gnarly side, temperature wise, a bit fresh. It's looking a bit slippy. Let's keep it steady. Now this is supposed to be a very, very scenic ride, and I'm not seeing a damn thing. Damn it. Just got to keep pushing through until we get to the clear. Oh, ruts, rocks and ruts, rocks and ruts, ruts and rocks. Ah. And low views. Appreciate you guys sticking around still. If you like this kind of stuff, give us a quick thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the video, feel free to. You can hit the notification bell when you want to see when I put a video out, but if you don't, that's not a problem. I don't really put them out there that often. Not at the moment. A bit time poor at the moment. It's time poor. It's just another excuse for being lazy, to be honest. Ah, back into the slop. Sorry, guys. Here we go again. Oh my god, power lines, look, civilization. Oh, we're looking good. That's a cracking view out there. That was fun. He's looking. He's not wrong, it was 12 degrees. Alrighty, let's do it. $40,000. And we are out of here. Watching out for all the dodgy kangaroos and wallabies, trucks, and other holiday makers. A little while to go now. Let's go have some fun. I'll kill that so I don't need the screen on. Love it. Great day indeed. On to the Oxley. Well, it's a bit breezy out here. Riders, Walcha is the motorcycle town. This is going to be great. Flex the body. All right, bit of motion lotion. We're going to pick that up right now. And then we should be good to go for the next couple of days. Where are you going? Done and dusted. We are good to go. Full tank. Oh, look at the bikes. That is awesome. We'll be there for brekkie hopefully tomorrow, depending on how we're feeling. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is Walcha. Oh, one outstanding run in, I tell you. It's been very, very cool indeed. Big enough town that's got a fair bit on. Oh, I'm looking forward to this. Here he comes. Out she goes. We'll come around. Thank you very much. Lovely. Man, what a great day that was coming up. So we're going to head into the showgrounds and then following Mark and Breno as we head in. Now, if you want to check out the channels that these guys have got, so Breno in front is the two-wheeled Sparky, and then you got Mark from Throttle Riding Adventures. Here we are at the rally. Let's go have a look. Alrighty, game on.